Ever wondered why your APK crashes on an Android emulator? Stick with me because I'll not only show you how to install your app on Android Studio emulator but also reveal why some APKs fail, and how to fix it. You're watching QuickFix Solutions, and we're diving in. To start, let's open Android Studio. I'm using Android Studio Ladybug, version the 1st of February 2024, but don't worry, any version works, even older ones. Next, click on New Project. If you've got an existing project, feel free to open that. For this tutorial, I'm starting fresh. Choose No Activity. Change the name to Test App. And hit Finish. If Microsoft Defender prompts you, select Automatically. This will add the necessary project paths to the Microsoft Defender extension list. You'll see a confirmation message saying, project paths were successfully added. Once the Gradle import process finishes, click on the Device Manager icon on the right and then the plus icon to create a virtual device. In the Virtual Device Configuration window, to select Hardware, choose a category based on your project. I'm selecting Phone and picking Pixel 8 Pro, but feel free to select a different one. Click Next. From the System Image window, select a system image. It's recommending a release with API 30. I'm going with Android 11, API 30, but you can choose another. Android Studio will download and install the API automatically if needed. Click Finish. Your virtual device should now appear under Device Manager as Pixel 8 Pro API 30. Hit the play button to launch the emulator, it'll work just like a real physical device. Before installing the APK, let's run Logcat to monitor the emulator's activity. Make sure your Android virtual device is selected. Logcat will generate tons of information as it tracks every activity on the emulator. By the way, have you tried using Logcat before? It can feel overwhelming. Drop a comment below if you need help navigating it. Now, let's install our APK. Drag the APK from the folder and drop it into the running emulator in Android Studio. The APK will install quickly. Before running the APK, type Python in Logcat's filter to track Python-related logs. Now, double-click the app to run it, and let's see what happens. Oh no, the app crashed. Let's figure out why. Type error into Logcat's filter to view Python-related errors. And there it is, OS error, file roboto-black.ttf not found. In my previous video, build a Kivy Python APK on Linux, step-by-step guide using VirtualBox. I intentionally left out the .ttf file in the extensions to show you how this can crash the APK. Make sure to check for missing resources like fonts or images in your Buildozer spec file. Have you encountered a similar error in your APK? Drop your story in the comments. I'd love to hear how you solved it. So, that's one reason our APK crashed. I'll show you how to test it on a physical device connected wirelessly to Android Studio in the next part of this series. And, don't worry, I'll make a separate video to fix this issue and show the APK running perfectly. Stay tuned. In part 2, we'll test the APK on a physical device. Be sure to subscribe to QuickFix Solutions so you don't miss it.